Tack. I will speak in English now. My presentation is about wind pumped storage system and the profitability assessment. This presentation is built on my master thesis from the University of Iceland, Faculty of Industry Engineering, Mechanical Engineering and Computer Science Department there. The outline is a very short introduction, and then I want to tell you about the equipment for wind pump and how it is connected with shaft technique. Then I will tell you about the profitability assessment, how it was done, and the result on a wind pump storage system using this shaft technique. In the end, I will mention other usage for wind pump storage system other than use it for backup power. And very short status of wind turbine usage in Iceland. Then I will, of course, expect some questions and hope you will feel free to discuss this matter. We have seen this a lot last days. This is the part I mostly will talk about today, the wind turbines and the pumps. This is of course used to create backup power by pumping the water to the upper reservoir through the pumps. This is the electricity production here. And then of course during peak hours the water is released from the upper to the lower reservoirs. The two main components are the pump and the wind turbine. In my calculations I used this centrifugal pump, pumps nearly 2 cubic meters per second, and it cost $30,000. The wind turbine to drive it is just wind turbine like Vistas V80, 2 megawatts. The price is estimated $2.4 million, and as I will show later, because I don't need a wind turbine, no generator or gearbox, the price is about 30% lower. Why is it estimated? It is because, for example, Vestas did refuse to give me any information about their project, so I didn't have any any prices from them. A shaft technique. the idea is to use a shaft-driven wind turbine, wind pump storage system. This is not a new idea. A shaft-driven pumps are used in rural areas like in America, where they pump water from the ground. But these wind turbines, they are multi-bladed with 20 or more blades. The idea here is to use a conventional wind turbine with 3 blades and shaft drive it by connecting the rotor to the pumps with 2 gearboxes with a shaft. Of course, there is no electricity production in Nakale, and therefore we don't need any expensive gearbox or generator. The tower in all my calculations are 50 meters. Of course, it can be more, 100 meters or more if needed. This has not been implemented yet, has not been built yet, as I know. The question about the profitability of a wind pump storage system will be answered in 2 ways. How powerful is a system like this with shaft technique? And is it profitable to produce electricity from pumped water in a hydropower plant with an added wind pumped storage system using this technique? We have a hydropower plant. We just add the system, wind turbine and pumps with shaft technique. We add, of course, the hydro turbine, and then we start to pump the water and we produce electricity from this added water. Is it profitable? first thing was to figure out the wind. The National Energy Authority in Iceland has built a wind atlas. All the calculations are about Sigalda power plant, and here is the receiver for Sigalda power plant, hydropower plant, Krókslón. The wind speed here is the average nearly 12 meters per second, and all the information about the Weibull information they provide are used in a Weibull distribution function, which where we can calculate, for example, how many days in the year the wind turbine is expected to be stopped. This calculation is also used when the power of the wind turbine is estimated. Here we have the power curve for Vestas VAT. The power curve is divided into intervals, 3 meters per second, and the average value is used. And with the wind speed information and the Weibull distribution function, the power was calculated in 50 meter height, about 1 megawatt. This was compared, how powerful is the shaft technique? It was compared to the electricity production system. And here we have the electricity production system. In 50 meter height, it produced nearly 1 megawatt. About 1 megawatt. Of course, it's expected to lose a little power with the electricity production and in the motor, and of course, the gearbox has the efficiency of 95%, and then we get 631 kilowatt. The shaft technique uses just two gearboxes, and the difference here in pumping water up to 40 meter high with this pump, the difference is about 10%, and it's and the shaft technique is better. This is of course just this calculation, because this has not been built, the system. The difference is not so much here in flow rate, but of course if a system like this are built like 20, 40, 100, it of course will count much more. to use in the profitability assessment, I made one unit installation. One unit is two wind turbines, four gearboxes, and two pumps. Then I can pump the water up to 80 meter height. This was for the Sigalda power plant, because the height there, the head there is about 80 meter high. And the wind speed nearly 12 meters per second. Other, like the pipe diameter was calculated, of course, it's nearly 1 meter. Pressure drop, half meter, maximum flow rate through this system is 1.8 cubic meters per second. So the question about the profitability is it profitable to produce electricity from pumped water in a hydropower plant with added wind pumped storage system? I chose 8 units to be installed, and and used a profitability assessment based on my work from my professor. It is in 10 parts, and it is made in Excel. For example, the breakdown part is where all the equipment is calculated, and the house, and what is needed. Profitability assessment like this can be of course used to calculate the profitability of many projects. If you want to calculate it for electricity, wind pumped storage based on electricity production, just have to change a few things in the breakdown, like the the generator and the gearboxes have been added, the cost of it. Some estimated share is like the maintenance cost, might used 2%, discount rate 10%, and loan interest rate 6%. Last week, the CEO of Landsvirkjun, the biggest electricity company in Iceland, told the media that they got 6.5% on refinancing while they were refinancing a new project in Iceland. So it's near. Annuity loan is expected to be for 20 years. And the planning horizon is 40 years. It's widely used for the lifetime of hydropower plants.